Hey guys, welcome back to the Entertainment Lab. I'm back with season 1 recap of Criminals UK. So without wasting time, let's jump right into it. And before that, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to never miss a video from us. Dr. Edgar Fallon is accused of raping and murdering his stepdaughter. Edgar's netball playing 14-year-old daughter was found dead in the woods with her skull smashed in. She was not a virgin at the time of her death. Edgar had sharpooned her on a netball trip, and as always, he had booked a hotel room with a double bed rather than two singles. The press interest in the case and Edgar remaining unusually tight-lipped mean that he's almost certainly go down if he doesn't start talking. After all, the jury read the newspapers. Once he start talking, he can barely stop. While he admits he can be angry and aggressive, he explains that he took his stepdaughter on a netball trip because it is allowed him to get away from his wife, who, for the record, was always the one to book the double rooms. His theory is the netball coach killed her. He found out they were having a sexual relationship, and when he did, he confronted her in the hotel room, eventually hitting and injuring her, but that, apparently, didn't dissuade her from seeing the man. Furious, Edgar apparently left without her. CCTV photographs seems to prove this. There's also the matter of his alibi. Being a doctor, Edgar is quick to point out the fact that dead body doesn't develop bruises. Based on the bruising found on the corpse, a certain amount of time must have been elapsed between her being injured by him and subsequently killed. And the photographs prove that in that intervening time, he had already left without her. It is a simple thing that trips him up, a receipt from petrol station. He didn't just fill up but had a car wash too. Why would he do that? It isn't much of a leap to assume that she might have been in the boot. And it easily proved the cast for her broken wrist shows telltale imprints on a boot mat unique to Edgar's Audi. The police have him. In Criminal UK episode 2, Queen Harley Atwell plays against type as a Cockney Louds accused of poisoning her sister's boyfriend. The victim's name is Roderick. It is mentioned multiple times and for various reasons, he is black. He also liked a drink, whiskey specifically, which Stacy would often pick up for him and drink with him while her sister was out. She liked a drink too. The story takes a darkened turn when Stacy says that one evening she turned up to find her sister badly beaten. Shortly after, she confesses to the crime. She says she gave Roderick rat poison. There's more to the story, and despite being seemingly content to allow her confession to stand, the detectives eventually decide to reconvince and get the bottom of the matter. Here is the real story. Stacy met Roderick and fancied him from the outset, but since her sister wasn't particularly outgoing when it came to men, she introduced him to each other. Before long, they were living together. And not long after that, Stacy and Roderick began an affair. The poisoning was both of their ideas. Stacy acquired the poison and her sister, Mary, gave it to Roderick. And Stacy promised herself that she would take all the fall since Mary had already been through enough. It was virtually an inevitability that Criminal UK would include an episode without immigration, and this is it. Jay is an accused of smuggling illegal immigrants into the country and then abandoning them to die once he became aware that the authorities were pursuing him. The two big questions of Criminal UK episode 3 are whether Jay really was transporting immigrants and, if he was, whether they were still alive. And the interrogation begins. Other similar cases are referenced to help raise the stakes. The matter of missing immigrants forms an effective dramatic ticking clock. Left alone in the trunk trailer, it is only a matter of time until they die. A major deviation occurs when Jay's solicitors picks upon something odd. After having made to wait in the corridor right by the vending machine and not seeing anyone help themselves to a drink, he is surprised to see Hugo, one of the interviewing officers, with a full mug. He claims coffee from a personal thermos since nobody likes the machine coffee. He even offers the solicitor a sip. But in the observation room, Paul takes a drink from his flask and discovers it contains vodka, throwing the entire case into serious jeopardy. In a moving moment, the officer decides that any potential consequences of continuing the interview are unimportant when compared to the fate of the human being who might be trapped in an abandoned trailer. Eventually, Jake gives up the location. The trailer's empty, no sign of human occupancy. It was a story of exploitation of not just immigrants, but hard-up Englanders who can be manipulated into making desperate decisions for the vague promises of financial recompenses. It was current and truthful, and the sheer number of people who might have been unmoved by the prospect of seeing many dead immigrants probably reinforce how smart of a decision it was not to include any. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like it, hit the like button, and for more such content like this, subscribe to our channel. And Criminal UK 3 is releasing on Netflix on 16th of September 2020. So do watch it.